Hello again, Science Explorers! It's Justin again, and welcome back to the incredible tundra. And look! It just started snowing! Last time, we spotted a caribou eating the grass and small plants in this area. It made me wonder if all of the animals in the tundra eat plants, or just some of them. In the savannah, we learned that animals that eat only plants are called herbivores. Join me as we investigate and learn more about the herbivores of the tundra. All right, science explorers. So we know that herbivores are animals that eat only plants. We saw the caribou eating grass, and a lot of it, so it must be an herbivore. But you know what I've been wondering ever since we left the savannah? What else makes an herbivore? Let's take a closer look. I've noticed that the herbivores we've seen, like giraffes and this caribou, have similar teeth. They have flat molars that are perfect for grinding and chewing tough plants. Look at this piece of an animal's skull that we found earlier. You can see its flat molars there. And they have sharp incisors, the front teeth here. What do you think these help them with? That's right, these sharp incisors help them cut through stems and leaves, making them easier to eat. But what about after they chew their food? How do they digest all of the plant parts they're eating? Wow, very interesting. Some herbivores have multiple stomach chambers because they need to break down tough plant fibers, and having more stomach chambers helps with that. Others have long digestive tracts to extract all the nutrients they need from their plant-based diet. Isn't that fascinating? Herbivores really are amazing. Their bodies are perfectly adapted to their plant diets. But these aren't the only ways they've adapted. As we learned in the savannah, animals find all kinds of ways to hide from predators and survive. Let's see if we notice any other ways they've adapted as we look around for more animals. Since we've been studying the caribou, let's start there. Last time we learned that their thick fur and body fat keep them warm, and their large hooves help them walk on snow and dig for food under ice. But look at those huge antlers on top of its head. How might those things help the caribou survive? Their big antlers help the caribou defend themselves against predators, compete with each other, and even help them dig in the snow to find food. And did you know these magnificent animals travel in large herds across the tundra? Why do you think they migrate or move from one place to another together? Well, they're very social, so they like being with each other, and they move in groups for protection. Sometimes they also travel long distances to find the best grazing spots. Ooh, I just saw something. It's an Arctic hare. Look at its beautiful white fur. Just like the Arctic fox, its fur changes colors to blend in with the snow. Their fur is very thick to keep them warm all winter long. And look at their ears. They're shorter than other rabbits' and hares' ears that I've seen. Why do you think that is? Use what we've learned in the savannah to help you record some ideas in your field notes. Their small ears help them hold on to as much heat as possible. These hares have long, strong legs for running quickly to escape predators. And they're very clever. They dig shelters in the snow to stay warm and hide from predators. Ooh, and look at this lemming! These little guys are fascinating. What do you notice about their fur color? Lemmings' fur color changes too, helping them blend in with the snow in winter, just like the Arctic hare. Lemmings live in burrows. How do you think this helps them survive out here in the tundra? It protects them from the cold and predators. The herbivores of the tundra sure do have a lot of adaptations that help them hide and blend into their surroundings. If the need to hide is such a big concern, there must be something to hide from, right? A predator. Well, that answers our big question. Does every animal in the tundra eat plants? No! Some of them must eat other animals. Next time, we'll see if we can find some of the predators that call the tundra home. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey.